Let us now understand how wholesale price index is computed through an example and what is the significance of WPI.
See, when it comes to wholesale price index, it measures the changes in the general price level of the country. So here, when I'm talking about WPI, I'm talking about the price level of the country. Now, this index is calculated mainly on the basis of those commodities which are traded on wholesale rate. Few examples would be your oil, sugar, wheat, rice, etc. So generally, the service sector gets ignored in this index. Now remember, there is only one composite WPI for the whole country. You can Google and see what exactly is the current WPI for the country. Now remember, this is done on a weekly basis and we get the press release or we get the notification through government bodies about them. Now remember, the methods of computing the wholesale price index is exactly same as the CPI. Okay, now remember, there are different categories when I'm talking about wholesale price index. So in India currently, we are following the base year of 2004-2005, okay? Also, in India, the construction for wholesale price index is being done under primary categories, fuel and power, and manufactured products. Now, primary articles are divided into subgroups of food articles, non-food articles, and minerals. There are around 102 commodities which are being included, and the weightage given is 20.118%. When it comes to fuel and power, there are 19 items which include your coal, petroleum products, etc. Even electricity would form part of it. The weight given is 14.91%. The major chunk is under the category of manufactured product because there are around 555 commodities which are included. So this would be your food products, beverages, textiles, metal products, etc. Okay, and they are forming 64.972%. Okay.